Alright, I just need to record this video really quick. I got some cool stuff here to show you. Let's dive deep. First things that weren't pre-orders this week, I grabbed both these off eBay because I realized after buying Following the Criterion, I only have 4 Christopher Nolan movies I didn't have, including that one. So now I just have 1 because I ordered these off of eBay because both these are out of print. And I was able to get them cheaper than just buying them off Amazon, even though I could still kind of get these off Amazon. Grab Memento on 4K. This is from Sony. So I'm assuming this will get a 4K at some point, but I got this for like 10 bucks. So whatever. It gets a 4K. Cool. I also would not be surprised that it gets a Criterion. This one, I'm not so sure about. It's released by Warner Brothers Insomniac, but you don't hear a lot about this one. I didn't even know this was a Christopher Nolan movie. It's got Al Pacino, Rob Williams, Hilary Swank. Never seen it. I've actually never seen Memento either, so those are on my list to watch. I think next Christopher Nolan movie, whatever year the next Christopher Nolan movie comes out, I will make sure I review all of his films and watch them all for the first time. That's something I want to do. Now let's get into the pre-orders. I got the latest High Republic book, or Star Wars The High Republic The Hunted. So I got that. Pretty sweet. And I got my comics this week as well, so we'll talk about those in just a second. But I want to rant about this. Let me actually go grab it. So, of course, I got House of the Dragon Season 1 on 4K when it came out. See how it's in this nice box? It's a nice edition. So, of course, when they announced Season 2, I expected the same. No, they changed the packaging. And this is just really terrible because I guess they line up the same, but you can definitely tell that something's off here, and that's really annoying. So you got this just a slip cover instead of this nice box. I mean, at least it says number 2 on the side, but that's still like, why are you changing the packaging on us as fans like that? Now, this time they did include 8 character cards, which is cool, I guess. Not necessarily sure I needed those. They're in this little thing. I'm not gonna open this up. I don't really care to do that. I'm gonna keep these sealed, right? But so it's just awkward because where do I store these character cards, right? In the slipcover? Well, they're just gonna fall out of the slipcover like all the time. So like if it was a hard box like this, okay, that's a really neat thing to include. But when it's like this, I don't understand this packaging decision here from Warner Brothers. I really enjoyed Season 2. I know some people liked it not as much as Season 1. Honestly, after sitting with it, I kind of agree, but it's still really good if you love the show. So it's a good show. Just disappointed that they changed the packaging on this. This is a really shitty thing to do to your customers. They know these people, they know us fans put our stuff on our shelves and want our stuff to match up. I don't know why they did this, but it is what it is. I'll live with it. At least we have their 4Ks, right? Because Warner Brothers could very well just go, sorry, it's a streaming exclusive show, no more physical. So, right. Always be grateful for things we have. Godzilla Skate or Die, issue number 5. Picked that up, and I picked up the last issue of the Kaboom Studios Garfield comic. I grabbed Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Naruto crossover, which is really cool. Can't get wait to get that. I got a Knuckles 30th anniversary one shot. Pretty cool. Definitely getting excited for Sonic 3 next month. And I got a latest issue of Space Ghost and Johnny Quest. Pretty sick. And I got this issue of Terminator. So, all really awesome stuff that I can't wait to dive into. I don't know what stuff I'm going to read first, but you know, let me know your thoughts, and subscribe. Thank you guys for watching.